Okay, guys, so this is one of those three red, blue, green jets you'll see inside of those television. But these have some pretty unique little hidden secrets inside of them, okay? So you'll notice right here, okay, there's a little button. It's kind of like, just like a primer ball on your lawnmower, all right? This is rubber, and you want to pay close attention here, all right? You want to have yourself a container, all right? Because you're going to breach this, all right? When we breach it, we're going to drain the fuel, all right? There is a fuel inside of this unit. Okay, guys, once I've taken, you know, the little PC boards off and I've lifted everything off, we wind up with four nice little copper coils, okay? These are pretty good sized copper coils, all right? Now, granted, you're probably not going to be able to unwind these because these are heated and they're put into a dip. It's like a lacquer, and they're compressed into their form, so they'll keep that form, okay? But if you were to go ahead and put these in, say you did, I don't know, your own bullet plating. This is copper you could use for that, or it can just go like I do in the scrap. So I put that off to the side. You're gonna get some assorted screws and stuff for all of us that have screw fetishes. These I just take down to the recycler. We have a guy that he turns them in. If I need any pots that are on here, or any capacitors, any resistors, I'll remove them, all right? If not, they'll just go down to the recycler. I always do pop off my big pieces of aluminum right here, though, and they go in my aluminum bin. So now we're left here with the tube, okay? Right here, still under vacuum. I don't mess with that. We've taken off the two mounts, so we now will separate the tube. This is the tube, all right? And that's going to go away. We're going to send that down to the recycler, and I'll use the glass and stuff, and then we're left with this unit. Okay, you remember how it looked right here, okay? This unit here. Now, for those people that are into video, each of these has a blue, a green. I mean, there's three of these in the unit. There'll be one blue, one green, and one red. This affords us that opportunity to use it. These are high quality filters, by the way, because obviously they're used in this stuff. Other things in here that you can use as well, and prepper tools too. So I'm gonna go ahead and take these apart now. They can be tough at first if you don't know, so there's a wing nut here. Take your wing nut off and obviously save those, and then you'll have the piece that the wing nut was on. All right, if you give that just a good, let me grab my pliers here, Mr. Unprepared. If you give that a good turn, all right, that's gonna allow you to take that unit off, all right? Now you've got that. Okay, guys, now once we've removed our four screws, okay, this unit here is going to pop right off. You got to release these screws, all right, to get to it. Okay, once we have all the screws off, we're able to lift this plate off. This will go in your steel, okay? It's going to be recycling for your steel. And then we have our aluminum plate, and here is our lens. Pops out now. It has a watertight seal all the way around to here. But what I thought was really cool was this is already designed for use in video, okay, and stuff. So you can get a real good idea of, all right, it's gotta be cleaned obviously because it had the oil all over it, but you can see you got a really good filter. All right, once we've popped them off, all right, I just used a little pair of pliers to get in there. You're gonna hold it carefully so you don't drop it, all right, but you're gonna pop it away. Now you see what's happening here. We've got different lenses, okay? Now, let's set him these here first. This is just a clear lens, but it has this shape to it, okay? It doesn't really have any magnifying properties, okay? I don't know what you would use this one for. It's a good plexiglass lens. I guess just hang on to it. Then you wind up with a very simple one, okay? This one is plexiglass, and it does have
some magnification properties, not a lot, good splinter lens.
But that's not the main baby we're after. What we're after is this.
A very, very high grade, and I do mean a very high grade and incredibly heavy, all right, magnifying lens.
What I got here is just a run-of-the-mill purpose oil lantern, kerosene lantern, all right. All right, we've got her opened up. She's empty, nothing. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna fill that with our mineral oil. Now, while I'm doing this, I wanna have a quick conversation. Don't anybody act goofy, okay? Always treat stuff like this as the bare minimum product, okay? Don't think it's food grade. Don't think it's good enough for using for, you know, like a laxative or anything like that at all. Don't be goofy, all right? You don't need someone to tell you to use common sense, but a lot of times as people see stuff like this, they hear the word mineral oil and they assume. Do not assume. Always treat stuff like this as the baseline product, okay? All right, I'm gonna have to give it some shaking because I didn't have time to let it soak in. Hopefully it doesn't affect how well. Let's see what we got here. Let's get you turned up there. Let's get a match. Let's see how we do. And we are lit. But remember, this isn't the same as kerosene, okay? So you're gonna have a different type of flame. All right, it's not gonna be as intense, okay, as you're gonna have in a kerosene, all right, because it's a much slower burner. But if you have two or three of these up, you're gonna be able to have a little bit of light. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that, all right? Sometimes it's hard to come up with new things that, you know, people haven't seen, all right? You don't wanna sit here and try to tell people the same thing that they've heard a million times and they're aware of. Although the Preppers Did You Know series is designed to keep your mind always thinking about those things, keep them fresh in your mind. I think this time we've showed you some really neat stuff, some great prepper tools, some video tools, you know, fuel. Those magnifying glasses, you end up with six total, three plastic and three high grade glass, really clear, perfect glass. Magnifying glasses that are expensive, so I mean, I think we showed you where you can harvest some other parts out of these DLP TVs and come up as a win. All right, so thanks guys for stopping by and checking it out. And we've been slow getting these going, but we have more ideas coming. All right, so hopefully you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.